Today, I'll be walking you through the Airbrake app to demo some key features. Let's get started. Airbrake signup only takes a few seconds. Once you're in, the installation is just as easy. We support most major languages and frameworks, so once you find your language of choice, simply select it and follow the quick start guide to easily install the Airbrake notifier and send your first error. Once we get that first error, you'll get access to your Airbrake error dashboard. This dashboard is a bit blank, so we'll transition to one with a bit more data. Perfect. From the errors page, you can keep track of all your errors by project. Let's click one to get more information. After you click the error, you can get more details in the form of four tabs. The first tab is a high-level overview of the error. From the second tab, we can get even more information about the occurrences of this error. As we scroll down, we can find things like a backtrace to get a more detailed understanding of the error. Additionally, we can see information about the session and breadcrumbs to get more context around exactly how the error occurred. From the third tab, we get aggregations. This is where you get to see the area of effect for an error. Airbrake provides a bunch of custom aggregations over a few parameters that users might find helpful in identifying exactly who or what was affected by an error. If provided aggregations from Airbrake don't quite match your needs, no problem. Airbrake offers custom aggregations so you can aggregate over parameters that are most important to you. For this demo, I'll also aggregate over user IDs so that I can see exactly which user IDs were affected by this error. Perfect. Now, I'll just go ahead and save this custom aggregation for my teammates just in case they need them later. On the final tab, you get to provide some context, add comments, notes, and feedback for teammates to help provide some insight around an error. Now that you've had a chance to explore the errors page, let's head over to deploy tracking to get more info on recent deploys. From here, we can see who deployed what and when. We can also see whether a deploy introduced a new error or fixed one. Now, on to performance. For application monitoring, Airbrake offers application error and performance monitoring, so users can manage the performance and availability of their application. At the top of the performance dashboard, you can get information on HTTP requests, response times, error occurrences, and user satisfaction, or APTEX. At the bottom of the performance dashboard, we can get more information on routes, queries, and jobs. Let's go ahead and click into queries and see what type of detailed information you can get. From here, you can identify any problematic queries. If any query took longer than usual, you'd be able to see it here. As the final part of the walkthrough, I'd like to quickly touch on Airbrake supported integrations. We support a wide range of integrations to help our users tie together their end-to-end error triaging workflow, so you can spend less time tracking down problems and more time developing.